students of class 12, subject physics, chapter 2, electrostatic potential and capacitance. This is lecture 2 and the topic is electric potential due to a point charge. So today we are discussing here the electric potential due to a point charge. In the previous session, students, I have already explained about electric potential at any point, which is defined as the amount of work done in bringing a unit positive test charge from infinity to a point. So here, calculating today electric potential due to a point charge. Now for this, let us assume that there is a positive charge at point O. Let us consider any point P, which is at a distance r from O. Suppose there is a test charge, generally we take the symbol for the test charge as Q naught, and let this point is A and this point is situated at a distance x from O. Now this is the situation that we are assuming over here. There is a charge, positive charge at O. There is a point P where we will calculate the electric potential due to this point charge. And this point P is situated at a distance r. Another thing that we have assumed is a test charge Q naught situated at point A. And this point A is at a distance of x from the point O. Now we have to calculate here the electric potential. To find the electric potential, let us assume that this charge Q naught is first of all shifted from point A to point B for a very, very small displacement. This displacement is taken as dx. Why dx? As you know that it is a very, very small displacement, and for that we take a symbol as dx. Now this charge Q naught, it is placed in the electric field. The electric field is present due to this charge Q. So a force, it is experiencing a force over here, F. And this force is given by the Coulomb's law. F is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. First charge is Q and the second charge is Q naught, divided by the distance x square. This is our first equation. And this force we have written according to the Coulomb's law. Now after this, as we are saying that, let us first of all find out the small amount of work done in shifting the charge from point A to point B. We are just doing this to make this derivation quite simple. So for this, we have the small amount of work done, dW is equal to, it is F dot dx. The small displacement is dx. And this can be written as F dx cos 180 degree. Because you know that A dot B is equal to AB cos theta, already studied. Now, after this, this can be written as dW is equal to F dx cos 180 degree is minus 1. So it is equal to minus F dx. These are equation number 2. So students, we have calculated the small amount of work done in shifting the charge from point A to point B. Now, what we have to do? We have to find actually the work done, the total work done in shifting the charge from this point infinity to point P. But what we did? We have only calculated the small amount of work done for this small displacement. To find out the total work done, we will integrate it now. So let's do it. The total work done is given by W. It is equal to integration of dW. To find out the net work done, to find out the total work done, we have to integrate it. It is equal to integration, the value of dW is written from this equation number 2, which is equal to minus fdx minus fdx. And with this, we have to integrate it from which point? From point this one, infinity up to distance r. So we'll take the limits infinity and the upper limit we'll take it as r. Now put the value of f. We are having f over here in equation number 1. Equation number 1 says that f is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q q naught divided by x square. So this value of f is taken over here. It is equal to minus infinity to r in place of f, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q into q naught divided by x square dx. Now outside the integration, the quantities that we can take, constants only. So constants can be taken as outside. Minus, what are the constants over here? 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, this is constant. Charges q, q naught is also constant over here. Now rest of the things, infinity, integration infinity to r. And with that, 1 upon x square, and 1 upon x square is written as x to the power minus 2 dx. Now we have to solve this part over here, and this is solved with the help of the formula. And that formula says, I am writing just over here, integration of x to the power n dx. It is equal to, this is a part of 11th class. So this is equal to x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. So using this formula, apply this formula in this, it will be equal to minus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q q naught integration. Now after this, x to the power minus 2 dx, when we'll integrate this, we'll get it equal to minus 1 upon x. Just do it with the help of this formula. And then we will place the limits also. This is after integration. So we'll write the limits. The lower limit is infinity and the upper limit is r. Then it is equal to, this is the minus sign it is cancelled. So rest of the things I am writing here, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q q naught. Inside I have 1 upon x, upper limit is r. So putting first the upper limit 1 upon r minus, then putting the lower limit 1 upon infinity. And 1 upon infinity is 0. 1 upon infinity is 0. So placing the value over here, it is equal to 1 upon infinity is 0. So I have the value of this work done is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q q naught divided by r. This is the total work done. This is the total work done. Total work done in bringing the charge from this point infinity to the point P. And this is only known as the electric potential at point P that we have discussed in the previous session. So this is the electric potential. So this can be written as V is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q Q naught upon R. So the electric potential at this point P is given by the expression 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q q naught divided by r. This is the expression for the electric potential due to a point charge given by V is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q q naught divided by r. Now if we have to draw a graph between V and r, then from this expression it is very clear that V is inversely proportional to r. And for such kind of relationship, we have the graph. This is for the vertical axis is showing the electric potential and horizontal axis is showing the distance over here. The graph appears this way. So this is the graph that shows the relationship between V and R.